digital classes and we are doing unit chemical bonding and molecular structure. Today this video I have made specially for those students who were still facing problem related to the theories valence shell electron pair theory and valence bond theory. Okay, so dear students, today I'm going to teach you in with the help of these notes, so please pay attention and watch the video full. And if still you are facing any problem, you are feel free to ask anything. Okay, so let's start. The topic is shapes of molecules with the help of different theories. Okay, so as the word of chapter is there, the name of chapter is there, chemical bonding and molecular structure. So in chemical bonding, we studied already, the chemical bonding is the attractive force between two type of element. You take example, suppose one element is then in the nature, that is H2. Second element in the nature, that is O2. When this H2 or O2 will react, when this H2 and O2 will react in a nature, then what will happen? It will mix, it will combine, and it will form H2O. Okay, I'm taking simple example. So like this way, H2 is also combined because of two hydrogen. Okay, two hydrogen combine, it form H2. Two oxygen combine, it form O2. So this H2 and O2 is known as molecular formula of hydrogen and oxygen. Okay, and this H2O is called molecule of H2 and O2 molecule. Getting about. So H2 will remain together until this is stable. O2 will remain together until this molecule will remain stable. Somewhere where stability is disturbed, the molecule will break down. Okay, so like this way the chemical bonding is formed. So we have different type of bonding, ionic bonding, covalent bonding, we have studied van der Waal force, hydrogen bonding, coordination bonding. Okay, but in generally, especially in covalent bond, if I'll say, basically what is happening in covalent bond, we have studied that the ionic bonds are formed as a result of electron transference and oppositely charged ions, which are held together in space because of some force of attraction. Since such force are non-directional, ionic bond are non-directional, so the structure of ionic crystal are influenced by relative size of ion. But in covalent bond, what is happening? The bonds are directional in nature because the shared pair of electron, you know that covalent bond is made up of a shared pair of electron. The shared pair electron, it remain localized in a definite space between the nuclei of the participant and the definite relative arrangement of the bond atom in a covalent molecule. Okay, so that those two elements which combine and form a molecule, so obviously molecule have some geometry. And what is the geometry? Now it is the definite relative arrangement of the bonded atoms, definite relative arrangement of the bonded atom in a covalent molecule. Okay, when in a covalent molecule the atoms are combined and they will form bond, these type of definite arrangement is called geometry of the molecule. So there are some factors that is necessary to make a molecule. There is bond length, bond angle, bond order. I mean, these are the three basic characteristics of covalent bond, which is helping us to identify the molecule, geometry of molecule, in which first is bond length. Bond length is the length, it is the distance between two nuclei. It is the distance between two nuclei. Okay, and because of this distance, we can predict the size of molecule. What would be the size of molecule? Smaller the molecule, element, smaller will be the size. Bigger the element, bigger will be the size. Second is bond angle. Bond angle tell us about the shapes of molecule. Okay, if suppose bond angle is 90 degree, the shape of molecule will be perpendicular. If bond angle is less than 90 degree, shape of the molecule will be acute. If the bond angle is more than 90, shape will be of obtuse, you know very well. Third is bond order. Bond order is telling us about the strength. You have already studied about single bond, double bond, triple bond, alkane, alkene, alkyne. So same thing is here. As you can take example of this. See here, between carbon and oxygen there is double bond. Why it is not single bond? there is some reason. So all those three parameters, these parameters are very important to understand the molecules. Okay, now generally let me take an example of carbon dioxide. This is the example of carbon dioxide. Okay, carbon dioxide structure we are discussing, in which carbon have 4 electrons. Now think like this way. Suppose if I take example of carbon dioxide, so I want to show you the structure of carbon dioxide. Suppose this is example of carbon dioxide. I made a small model of carbon dioxide. This is carbon, these two are oxygen, and the carbon and oxygen are bonded with the help of double bond. Carbon and oxygen are bonded with the help of double bond. Why it is double bond? Now let's discuss with the help of electron dot structure. So dear students, we know very well the carbon and oxygen have the carbon. If we'll talk about carbon, the number of electron in carbon is 6, because atomic number of carbon is 6. So we will divide the number of electron according to Bohr's distribution. So how many electrons are there in outermost shell? Obviously this is outermost shell, 4, and these 4 electrons will be donated show in carbon like this way, electron dot structure. You know very well, we did Lewis structure, in which electron dot structure is very important to form a bond. Now why the carbon will react with oxygen? Now this is oxygen atomic number is 8, so it means that there are 8 electrons. So 2 and outermost shell have 6 electrons. Now just tell me, what is more easy, to make this 4 to make this 4 8 or to make this 6 8? Yes, to make 6 8 it need 2 electrons. To make 4 electron, to make 4 8 it need 4 electrons. So it is easy, I think this is easy to make 8. Okay, so what will happen? We will make electron dot structure of oxygen. So these are all electron dot structure of oxygen. So how many oxygen is there in carbon dioxide? 2. So one we will make this side, one will make right hand side, one will make left hand side of the carbon. Now see, in nature when this carbon gas and oxygen gas are coming closer to each other, suppose when in nature the carbon gas and the oxygen gas, let me take example, suppose this is a carbon somewhere in nature and this is oxygen somewhere in nature. When this oxygen will come closer to carbon, what will happen? The carbon have 4 electron and oxygen also having 6 electron. These 4 electron, due to these two, because oxygen need how many electron? 2 electron. So this side there is only 1 electron. So automatically this electron will come here. This side electron is 1. This side also the electron will come this side, and it will form a new type of electron dot sharing. New type of electron dot sharing. Okay, like this way. New type of electron dots. Earlier it was carbon have 4 direction electron. Now carbon have only 2 direction electron. These 2 electron of these 4 electron are of carbon. 1, 2, 3, 4. These are of the oxygen. Okay. Now how the bond will form? How the electron will form? Now see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It means that oxygen made up their octet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It means that oxygen make octet. So this oxygen is satisfied now with 8 electron. Now this oxygen is satisfied with 8 electron. Now this carbon, we need to discuss about the carbon. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8. So this carbon also make its octet. So in this way the carbon dioxide is a stable structure. Okay, and when we are going to make the structure will be written, you know, very well, one pair of electron is one bond, second pair of electron is second bond. So it means that 4 electron are there, 2 pair, the double bond. When in case of nitrogen there is 3 pair, so we will write nitrogen triple bond. When there is in case of hydrogen single pair, so we will write H single bond. Okay, this is bond order: single bond, double bond, triple bond. These are called bond order. Okay, that we studied in previous video. So hope so you understood this, why carbon dioxide have this shape. Now if once carbon dioxide have this shape, this type of shape, you can see the bond length. This is bond length. This is basically, we will tell bond length. This from this atom to this atom, it is bond length. This is bond length. Bond order is 2. And bond angle, you can see this is a linear straight bond angle is 180. So one bond angle is 180, which shows the shape. Shape is linear. Shape of bond, shape of carbon dioxide is linear. Bond angle is 180. Bond length is size of the distance between oxygen and carbon's nuclei, and bond order is double. Okay, when you will study, yeah, with the help of structure, when we come to know about bond length, bond angle, bond order, it is final that you have studied the structure of molecule. But there are basic theories which help us to predict the study of geometry. These are Bessper theory, valential electron pair repulsion theory, in which number of bond pair and lone pair decide the shape of molecule. Second, balance bond theory, on the basis of overlapping or hybridization, we are going to predict the shape of molecule. Third is molecular orbital theory, on the basis of bonding and antibond. How many bonding, how many antibonding? This theory is going to tell us about the bond order. Okay, how hydrogen have single bond, how nitrogen have double bond, how helium have no bond. So these things we are going to know from bond molecular orbital theory, that I'm going to make the video tomorrow. So let's start. First theory, valential electron pair repulsion theory. Nothing is new, my dear students, which I have taught you in previous two video. Today, just because of your doubt and your query, I am making all the same. I'm going to tell you about the same topics. Okay, the valence shell electron pair theory is valence shell electron pair. It means that why electron will pair up? It will pair up to complete its octet electron, because of to complete its octet electron will pair up. Second is repulsion theory. So obviously when two electrons are coming closer to each other, first two electrons will attract. Okay, but due to this attraction electron-electron, some repulsion will cause, and in which bond pair are repelling very less, then lone pair, bond pair, then lone pair, lone pair. What is lone pair now? Lone pair is that those pair of electron in which electron which is not making bond with any other element, that is called electron pair. Okay, so the shape of molecule, it is given by Gillespie and Nahlholm, you can say, in 1957. According to this theory, the shape of a molecule depend upon the number of electron pair. The shape of molecule depend upon the number of electron pair. Yes, the shape, suppose here how many electron pair is there? 1, 2, 3, 4. It means the shape will be like somewhere four directional, that is tetrahedral. Tetra mean four. Because of why tetra word is 4? Because 4 pair of electron is there. Okay, then this is linear because 2 pair of electron is there. Very simple. Let me tell you the basic mantra. If 2 bond is there, then linear. 3 bond is there, triagonal. Tri mean 3. If 4 bond is there, tetrahedral. 5 bond is there, trigonal, bipyramidal. 6 is there, octahedral. Okay, 7 is there, pentagonal, bipyramidal. So like this way you will learn, so you will recognize. Second, postulates of valence bond theories, valence shell electron pair repulsion theories. The electron pair around the central atom tends to repel one another since the electron cloud is negatively charged. Yes, in which lone pair will repel more. Lone pair will repel more. Suppose you can see here the repulsion between these two bond is more than the repulsion between these two and these two. Okay, this is called repulsive force. Third is the multi bond is treated as if it is single bond and electron pair which constitute the bond may be repulsive attract. It means that triple bond is more stronger. ट्रिपल बॉन्ड इज मोर स्ट्रॉन्गर देन डबल बॉन्ड देन सिंगल बॉन्ड. Why? Because triple bond is very small. You take example, if suppose, if I will say this is triple bond. If I'll take example, this is triple bond. So these two atoms are bonded with very strong force or not, because three side force is there. 1, 2, 3. Whereas if double bond we will talk, the double bond have less force. This is double bond's force. So you can take example of double bond. This is double bond. So this is having less force. This double bond have less force than this triple bond. Okay. Then this single bond. Getting a point? This double bond, this triple bond have more stronger than double bond than single bond. So this single bond will easily we can break. But this double bond need little bit energy. This triple bond required more energy. Okay. So like this way, we can see. The triple bond is more stronger than double bond than single bond. So this is all about balanced shell electron pair theory. Now we will see the balanced bond theory. As we have studied, balanced shell electron pair repulsion theory is based on number of lone pair and bond pair. So the balanced bond theory is based on concept of atomic orbital and orbital configuration of the atom. It is given by Hitler and London in 1927, but later on modified by Pauling and co-worker. They has modified it in the form of hybridization. Okay, in the form of hybridization. The hybridization is very important to understand the concept of structure forming. So let's understand, maybe two hydrogen is there. Let me take example, this is one hydrogen, this is second hydrogen. Maybe in nature surrounding there are two hydrogen, both the hydrogen have single electron only. Those single electron is not stable. Like this have hydrogen have single electron and this hydrogen have single electron, but these two single electron are not not satisfying their stability. So what will they will do? They will come closer, they will donate these single electron, they will form a molecule which is called H2 by satisfying duplet. And while they are attracting each other, while they are attracting, they are coming closer to each other and they attract, they will release some energy. Both hydrogen will release some energy. The energy releasing is 433 kilojoule mole inverse in case of H2. And when it will break down, repelling, that time energy is required to repulse. It means that very simple, dear student, this is keep for forever in your mind. Whenever bond is breaking, जब बॉन्ड टूटता है डिकम्पोजिशन द एनर्जी रिक्वायर्ड टू ब्रेक दैट बॉन्ड एंड व्हेन एवर बॉन्ड इज कंबाइनिंग फॉर्मिंग इट रिलीज सम एनर्जी ये एनर्जी को छोड़ता है ओके दैट्स व्हाई द 4.433 किलो जूल मोल इनवर्स इज रिलीज्ड बाय H2 नाउ एटम व्हाई एटम इज कंबाइंड एटम कंबाइंड टू गेट द स्टेबिलिटी H इज कंबाइंड विद H टू गेट स्टेबिलिटी व्हेन टू हाइड्रोजन एटम अप्रोच each other, the overall potential energy of the system decreases. Therefore, a stable molecule of hydrogen get formed. Okay, let's understand the formation of H2 with the help of orbital electronic configuration. So, dear students, you know about orbital. This is 1s orbital, 1s orbital. Hydrogen have 1s and 1s orbital. So, 1s electron, second 1s electron. This is electron of hydrogen, this is electron of hydrogen. But in both the case it is unstable because it is not pair. Until the electron will not pair full field outermost shell, it is not called stable. So they will share the electron. Suppose this hydrogen will share electron to this hydrogen and they will combine here, form H2, 1s2 molecule. And while they are forming, how the energy is transferring? This is HA. HA, when HA's electron is going to be this electron is going to be merged with the second hydrogen, so it will lose the force this side, and while bonding it will give the electron toward this side. Okay, electron is moving toward this, but vice versa, this also needs stability, so the HB electron of HB EB it will go toward HA and they will combine together. They will remain forever together with a very simple, molecule. Okay, very simple, like this way. H is coming. This is the electron of H, and it will form and it will remain together. This is H two molecule, okay, by sharing the electron. But this concept is more clear in hybridization. This concept can be clear by hybridization process. Although I have not written theory, so let's try to understand what is hybridization. Hybridization word came from hybrid, and hybrid is an English word which is called mix. So sometime you might have heard about this flower is hybrid flower. You might had heard it in biology also. Hybrid is the in which the I can say in which the quality of two things came, okay? Like mule is the hybrid of horse and donkey. Mule species is the hybrid of horse and donkey. So the same way, the hybrid come when two atom mix. When two atom mix, it will form one molecule. The molecule is hybrid. So we need to see if any molecule we are discussing, there are basically three type of orbital: s orbital, p orbital, d orbital. We already studied in chapter 2. S orbital have spherical shape, p orbital have lobe dumbbell shape, d orbital have double dumbbell shape. Okay, basically s is only one, p we have three type of shape, x, y, z, and d we have five shapes: dxy square y square, dxy, dzx, and d y z square. Okay. Now, dear students, when suppose any two atom is coming closer to each other. Suppose I am taking example of HCl. Now you need to see which two elements are there. One is H, second is C. Now you need to write the number of atom. There are a number of electron: hydrogen 1, chlorine 17. So configuration of one is 1s1, whereas the 17 is 1s2, 2s2. 2p6, 3s2 and 3p5, because 2 plus 2, 4 plus 6, 10, 11, 12, 5, 17. Okay, now we need to focus on outermost shell. Outermost shell has one electron, here outermost shell 5 electron. So we'll make hydrogen's orbital 1s, and this is outermost shell only one electron, whereas in case of chlorine, we need to make 1s have 2 electron, then 2s have 2 electron, then 2p have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 electron. This which the way I am filling the electrons, which rule is this? In second chapter we already studied, this is a rule which is called Hund's rule. Okay, Hund's rule, in which we cannot fill electron until single electron will not fill in all the orbital. Then 3s have 2. Now 3p have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So you can see somewhere this orbital is unfilled. Am I right? This orbital is unfilled. Whereas this side also electron is not there. So what will happen? This hydrogen electron will transfer to this orbital. And this is the orbital of s spherical. This is the orbital of p, I can say z. This is the orbital of pz. Am I right? This is pz because it is 2px, 2py, 2pz. So this is the orbital of 2pz. This is the orbital of 1s. When s orbital will overlap, now I am making here, when s orbital of hydrogen will overlap the p orbital of chlorine, it will overlap. Ek electron diya na isne yahan par. The electron which is hydrogen has given, that will overlap and it will form sp hybridization. Okay, this is called sp hybridization because 1s 1p hybridization. Like this way, you can take example of H2O. H2O is sp2 hybridization because hydrogen is from s and oxygen is from p. Okay, like this way we can understand the hybridization process. So sp hybridization will come from 1s 1p. When it will combine, it will form sigma bond. It will form when end to end it will overlap. When it will overlap side to side and end to end, you need to understand what is the meaning of end to end and side to side. Okay, suppose this is p, suppose I am taking this is p and this is s. Suppose s and p is this is s, suppose this is p and this is small is s. When S and P is going to be combined like this way, this is called SP hybridization. If now suppose one more S is there. So this is S. One more P, not S. One more P I want to fix here. Now suppose I will take example of this. This become now SP2 molecule. Okay, that is called SP2. Now if one more we will fix here, then we will come to know that is SP3. Okay, SP3 molecule. Chalo, I am going to take example of SP3. Suppose this is the example. You can see here SPPP. So 1s 3p. So this become SP3 hybridization. Okay, SP1 is very simple. This is you can take example of SP 1s 1p. When it will overlap, so it will form SB. SP2 1s 2p SP2. Okay, and this is SP3 hybridization. Like this way we have SP3D2 also. We have SP3D2 also. Up to these three I made. This is the hybridization between S and P. Now SP3D2 also we have. SP3D3 also we have. Okay, this is forming 6 bond. This is forming 7 bond. These are forming 4 bond. One more is there, that is SP3D is also there. So basically we have how many hybridization? 1 2 3 4 5 6. This is forming linear shape because 2 bond is there. This is forming trigonal shape because 3 bond is there. This is forming tetrahedral shape because 4 bond is there, 3 plus 1. This is forming trigonal bipyramidal because 5 bond is there. This is forming 6 bond octahedral. This is forming pentagonal bipyramidal 7. Okay, so now dear students, one table I have shown you when in the last in my last video. So maybe you have studied that table, and the table is representing the hybridization, and this is the table also where number of bond you have to make like this way. This table, number of bond hybridization S1S1P. So it is total 2, 1s, 2p, it is total 3. So this will, when sp hybridization is there, it will give a linear shape. When 3 is there, it will give trigonal shape. It will 4 when it is tetrahedral shape. So this thing we will do tomorrow. I will make tomorrow this video. So hope so today whatever I taught that you understood, and you understood the matters or the your queries. I was able to solve your queries. Hope so you like this video. So this is all about for today. Watch this video carefully. This is very important video, if I will say. And this video is telling us about how structure is having basic geometry. So thank you. Take care yourself. Stay home. Stay safe. And till my next video, stay enjoying digital classes. Okay, keep enjoying digital classes. Thank you. Thanks a lot. As usual, I'm doing nowadays. That is, please take care of yourself. Take care of your family. Stay home. Stay safe. And don't be corona carrier. Be corona warrior. So have a nice day. Thank you very much for watching this video. Thanks a lot.